How we doing, guys? Going in on episode 2. Seems like we got a decent amount of positive feedback from that first episode. Like 3 Snapchats and a text message that said good job. So said, let's go number 2. I think we're heading to one of our favorite spots, Lupe's. It was a go-to senior year of high school. So if you guys enjoy this place. Where we started from. Well, hustles grab your to shadow weighs a ton. Driving down the 101. Yeah, you guys definitely got to try this spot. I'm assuming most of my followers are people that I know, and I'm assuming most of you guys have heard of this place. It's good. Definitely a recommendation. I think I've found better now, but this is like the one that brought me into the California burrito scene. So you guys got to try this place out.
Back in high school, I'd say probably about 50.
A month?
Yes.
So as you can tell from how many times Kevin used to go there a month, this was like the spot that introduced me and all of our friends to California burritos and where we really developed like a true love for them. So yeah, you guys definitely got to try this spot. I'm assuming most of my followers are people that I know, and I'm assuming most of you guys have heard of this place. It's good. Definitely a recommendation. You guys got to try this place out.
At Lupe's, I usually get a California burrito. Their salsa there is also really good.
I really wish on these videos I could show you guys the inside, like the ambiance and stuff of these restaurants, because there's some pretty cool spots. Taco Sam is dope, Lupe is pretty sick, but it's we're in COVID season, July 2020, so we're only doing pickups right now. We got lucky last time at Taco Sam, we found a table outside to sit down and eat, but there's no seats at Lupe's. All right, guys, we got our California burrito. As I said, what's the basic? It's a tortilla. Look at this thing. Fire. My favorite about this place is we got a habanero salsa. It's really gas. And that's like a salsa verde. I'm colorblind, actually, so I don't know which one's which. One of them's. Some of them. Is it? Yeah, okay, yeah, it's habanero. Let's get a bite action. Alright, guys, just took a bite. Think about Lupe's and Taco Stand. Lupe's is like my home ground territory, and then Taco Stand's San Diego friend. It's always been a debate which one's better, but I'm gonna have to give this one an 8-3. I think Taco Stand takes the slight dub. It's close. I like Lupe's tacos better, though.
With the habanero salsa, I give my burrito a 7.
Yeah, as I said, the California burrito from Taco Stand might be a little bit better, but these Lupe's tacos are gas. So that burrito was $9.89 before tax. I also add chipotle sauce, which is about another $1. It's not bad. It comes out to be like $11.50, $12-ish, but like Taco Stand was $1 less, and the chipotle sauce is free on the side. So yeah, I guess Taco Stand is a little bit better, but keep going around and find some other places.
Don't forget to like and subscribe.
Thanks for watching episode 2 of Cali Critique. Hope you guys enjoyed. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Time of peace, when the Avatar kept balance between water tribes, Earth Kingdom, Fire Nation, and Air Nomads. But that all changed when the Fire Nation attacked.